WPS is built in a modular fashion, which allows for painless and easy updates, and it allows you to turn off any individual updates you don't like at any time. That's a really unique feature of this software, and it means you can accept updates without having to worry about getting back to a previous version. Let's take a look. When you start WPS, this indications notifier tells you if any new updates have been posted. Click on it to bring up the notifications window. Looks like there are 4 updates for me to install. If I click on that, I get some more information. Looks like it's a high priority, and I just click here to do it. It tells me exactly what's about to change. Looks good. So I hit next, and it downloads the new modules. Another reminder that we're about to install 4 plugins. And it reminds me to restart WPS. I'll do that. And we now see there are no more updates. Perfect. I love how easy that is. But the best part is you can undo any of those at any time. Just go to Tools where you can see different kinds of things, but we want to see the plugins. Looks like I have 79 plugins installed, and I can see which ones are active. And I can even search to see which ones are specific to my device. The currently highlighted one has a link that tells me everything I need to know about that plugin. Now, unfortunately, I don't read Portuguese, but I can copy the text, bring up the Chrome web browser, and type translate, open quote, paste my text, end quote, and just like that, I get an English translation that tells me what I need to know. Armed with that information, I can simply select the plugins I want to turn off and click on Uninstall. Now, I don't want to uninstall these, so I'm not going to hit the button, but you get the idea. You can also simply deactivate or activate a plugin. So with WPS, you have complete control over the update process and never have to worry about an update interfering with something you're working on. Very cool. Here's a little trick to make the translation process even easier. Go to Tools, Options, and make Chrome your default browser. Now when you select Plugin, Installed, highlight one, and click on the description, it comes up in Chrome. Chrome will usually ask you if you want the whole page translated, and just like that, it's all done for you. If it doesn't come up automatically, just click on the Translate button. That's a whole lot easier than that cut and paste stuff we did earlier. Click here to learn more about the CFW-300 family of drives. Click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free award-winning support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.